Hey, good morning. My name is Ben Victorica and I work for Notable Solutions. And today I'm recording a video on how to use AutoStore plus a Ricoh copier to scan documents automatically into your customer's existing folder structure, allowing them to browse for which folder they want to scan into and give them options for different file types. So down here, I'm simulating a property management company that has different tenants. And here is AutoStore where I'm using these three components. The Ricoh capture component, Abby to convert file types and routing it to the folder that the customer dynamically picks from the Ricoh copier device. I'm gonna go into Ricoh and let's add a form. Let's make this form name scan to tenant file. We're gonna have fields here. Let's create one for folder location. Let's create one for document type. Let's create one for notes and file type. So under folder location, we're going to change the type here to folder browse, and we're going to point it to a root folder, Chattanooga, and here's the same folders that you see below, right? So we're going to point it to the root, Chattanooga. Then the document type, we're going to make that a string list and put the common document types or whatever the customer gives you for document types. So lease, complaint, maintenance, repair, other, invoice, select from list. That's going to be our default. Then we're going to leave this as notes, and file type is going to be also a list. And we're going to activate it based on what the customer selects. We're going to activate Abby in different ways. If they select they want a Word document, Abby's going to use DOCX and convert it to Word. If they select that they want a PDF, Abby's going to use that and convert it to PDF. If they select they want Excel, Abby's going to use XLS and convert it to Excel. And we'll make PDF the default. Now we select OK. We're done with the field types. We'll go to Components. We're going to go to Abby. And we're going to activate Abby. Here under pass-through documents, I'm going to drag over the file type. So I drag this file type so I can copy it and paste it here. See, these are the choices that you have in Abby for converting file types, but you can't drag over this field, but you can paste it. So when I hit paste, this is the field that we're going to be using dynamically based on what the user selects. So pass through documents, we need to change this to a no. We're now done with Abby. We'll hit apply and OK and send a folder. Based on what the user selected, we're going to route to that folder. So using these RRTs and folder location, that's what the user had selected. For rename file, we're going to rename it first based off a document type. Then we're going to use the notes. If there are no notes, there'd be nothing. And then we're going to use a counter and an extension. Always good to put these two, and you can drag them together. Now we're done with our configuration. Let's select OK. And OK. And OK. And we're going to save this file. Okay, now we have our Ricoh device here, and we can see what the user experience is going to be. Let's say they want to scan a file here into the Phoenix Apartments where their tenant is Jake Young, and they want to scan a lease and convert it to Word and route it right here. From the copier, they would select scan to tenant file. They would then select folder location and they would browse Phoenix Apartments, Jake Young. Then they select the document type. Maybe this is a lease and they want to convert it to Word. They don't need any notes, but watch what happens if I put a note. New contract. And select file type and make that Word. I put the documents in the feeder and I select start. So now based on this information, we will have routed it to Jake's folder and we named it based off of the information that we had created. So thank you very much for watching this video, and we look forward to working with you on the next project.